Back like I never left, live from the Living Room Podcast with Jay Rich. Got Crystal back in the building. It's going to be problematic. I wouldn't have it any other way. First things first. Have you ever heard of sleeve?
Oh my God. Yeah. The things that the male strippers wear?
Huh? Wait, what? Like, it's like an artificial joint? Oh, okay.
That or their like actual fabric.
Okay, that's different from what I was
talking about.
So what I was told about yesterday was like, I guess like it's like a weird section of Pornhub, I guess. Where they use like the fake joints. Like it's not like the girls that like got the joints where they just stick them on the wall and they, you know, had any fun with it.
Okay.
It's like a guy will put one on
instead of using his own.
Right.
Yeah, I've seen that too.
Seen it? Okay. Yeah, is that normal at this point, or is it what? Does it do something for the guy?
I would hope not.
Okay, because I was about to say, it's like, what is it? What could it be doing for you if you got a joint on your joint?
Yeah, because are you using that instead of a condom, or is that what?
I think it's. Huh? No, I haven't seen it. I just had women explain it to me because like. I guess it was more entertaining that way.
It could be. But I could see that. Like a Caucasian male with a African-American one.
No, I didn't. You took it the wrong way, but that's great too. I was saying it's more entertaining for me to actually hear the story sometimes. Like, sometimes instead of watching a movie, you watch the memes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's more entertaining than the movie. Like, that's what I was talking about. But that right there, yeah, you talking about, like, you know, got a whole new shade of life.
That would be something entertaining to see. That's crazy. I'm going to make sure I search that when I leave.
Don't watch without me. We in this together. We're going to do a whole reaction video. Oh, he got a veiny one, too, on top of that.
I'm going to turn the sound off.
Oh, the sound off. Well, apparently they got a thing where it actually shoots. Like the fake jizz.
That's too much. That makes me think of like the babies, the toy babies that they have, the Cabbage Patch. They're not Cabbage Patch, but they're, you know, the newer babies the newer baby dolls that they have for kids.
What that they produce?
Pee and poop
and stuff.
Spit and yeah, word? All of that. Yeah, it's weird.
I don't have kids, so you just put me on something that made me, fearful.
I mean, my daughter's not that young anymore, so she never experienced it, but I've seen it in stores for some reason.
Okay. Yeah. Of your body parts, which part aged the fastest? For most of y'all women, it's y'all check engine light come on with y'all knees.
age.
Like, my back ain't what it used to be. Be careful. I got this hip. It can go in any minute. I got 3 dips in me.
Not for me, but yeah, knees would probably be one. But your feet.
Your feet?
If you want them.
I was about to say, you work a lot, so.
Because, you know, I ain't no stay at home, nothing.
Yeah, yeah.
So I ain't sitting behind no desk.
Gotcha. I'm
gonna get out there and get it.
So. Okay. You said something earlier before we got started. What's your internet history that somebody would judge you for? Oh, man. Yeah.
A whole lot of Amazon. Pornhub, Xvideos.
What's your section or like what's your bag? It's on. Spin my mouth.
Yeah. That.
Oh, word?
That. I see a lot of that, a lot of choking, probably a lot of hardcore. I stay in the hardcore
section wrestle?
A lot. The, like, choking and, like...
You want to wrestle? So,
you know, I don't really got time for real. But, you know,
our reaction video is going to get live.
But, yeah, I stay in the hardcore section for some reason. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's just because of me.
Okay.
Like to see other people getting... up and fuck and
oh, that's the vibes.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right.
People getting manhandled. It don't even matter if you man, woman. Don't matter. I just want to see somebody get.
You messed me up a second ago when you said Amazon because I thought you were talking about like the. I think I've seen like there's a position called Amazon.
Yeah, there's a category for like bigger women.
No, well, that too, but I was talking about, there's an Amazon position, like a sex position. Never heard of it. We got another reaction video. We're gonna
I need these links.
Got you. It's that Beyond section. It's like you go to Bed Bath and Beyond, it's like the Beyond section. You're like, whoa. Y'all make these?
That's crazy.
Never knew.
I gotta be more exploring.
Yeah. It gets weird very fast. Yeah. Who do you disagree with, but they're still in your life? Who do you disagree with the most?
Okay, so I'm a middle child. I have an older brother between, mm-hmm. that's in between myself and my oldest brother.
Okay.
So we disagree the most. Because I can't let go of who he used to be.
Okay.
You know, he's very promiscuous. He was.
Mm-hmm.
He was a changed man, let him tell it.
Okay. Let him tell it.
Yeah, let him tell it. I can't let go of that person.
Why?
Because he's one of those brothers that I pleaded with. Like, don't date my friends. Like,
oh, he was that brother.
And he went behind my back and did it anyway.
Yeah.
So it's like now it was up from there.
But you made him the forbidden fruit, though. That's kind of your fault.
Nah.
Did you tell your friends not to mess with your brother?
Why? Why do I have to have that conversation?
You don't have to. I'm asking if you did.
No, I didn't.
Okay. Did you present a lot in any type of way, like, y'all shouldn't mess with him, or, like, you kind of shoot him away when you come around with your girls?
It was just...
You gave him a speech, and he just didn't respect it.
Basically.
Okay.
Basically.
Okay.
And it was just up from there, because it was just like, you know, the way I found out was real, like,
her too? And Stephanie? You call it Heffany?
And then when it was over, it was like, it was my fault. But like,
the girl caught feelings and then she'd come to you telling you about your brother?
Nah, he did.
What, telling you about the girl?
He caught feelings and I'm assuming that
he not holding properly then.
Listen.
I thought hoes didn't have feelings.
But you know.
Oh, she went right to the rapper hands.
You know what I'm saying? But he caught feelings. I'm assuming that she deaded.
So he stopped. Situation. So he stopped being a hoe, and then you won't let it go.
I don't think he stopped. But
now I hope his sister. Oh, he got a girl. Mm-hmm. Oh, she don't see this.
No, she won't. I don't think she like me.
Okay. Yeah. Next question. Mm-hmm. What's the worst music you had in the background while I was getting it on? Getting to it. I'm like, this is a weird thing to get my cheeks clapped to.
It was actually Euphoria playing in the background. I ain't gonna lie.
Somebody had an OD.
Somebody OD'd
while you was on the D.
I think somebody, no, not even. Somebody was getting their ass whooped.
Okay.
And I was just like, part of me wanted to say, yo, cut it off. But like, part of me like didn't want
you need the closure
to stop happening. So I was just like,
oh, yeah.
We just gonna, mm-hmm. we just gonna let it rock. I'm just gonna tune it out.
Game player, but team player, right there.
It was tough. It was tough.
She was locked in. Mamba mentality.
I was. Sheesh.
Sheesh.
I'm having flashbacks.
What's worse? You said flashbacks?
Go ahead.
You had a little twitch, ain't it?
A little bit.
A little twitch on them.
Jesus, right. It's hard.
What's worse? Paper straws or condom head?
I don't know what condom head is. I've never experienced that, so I wouldn't know.
You went straight to the meats? Straight to the meats.
Yeah, you know.
So we're getting both with paper straws?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's fine.
All right.
Oh my god.
Oh, all right. I wasn't. Never mind. We here now.
Nah.
We here now. We here now.
We can revisit.
I mean, have you ever finished a drink with a paper straw? Yes, no?
Yeah.
Did you get a little paper at the end? Mm-hmm. It's like, I don't know, I guess people, this is black blasphemy, but I don't like you get that, what's the cereal that all the black people like?
Captain Crunch.
No, Captain Crunch. You know, if you like your the last pieces of it is all soggy and you mess up the roof of your mouth. Mm-hmm. That's why I feel like paper straws do at the end of the drink.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna finish what I bought.
She's a finisher, boy. Mamba mentality.
Damn.
Damn. All right. Go. keeping on with the We Here Now movement. We want answers. Have you ever had somebody try to hit you with a trap, baby? Or have you tried to, you know, slide one up?
Oh, hell no. I ain't trying to trap nobody, but yeah, I did. I was gonna say yeah, I was trapped per se.
Yeah. I was. How did you find out? He told you, missed an argument, or he kind of like let it slip one time?
It was two things. Okay. One, okay, so you know, because you know me,
but yeah.
The condom we was using. I looked at it after the fact, and I was just like, all right, you know, I ain't really a dude, so I don't really know.
What were you looking for? Like,
it's just like, it needs some milk. Something said, look at it, and I did, and it just didn't.
Was it on to begin with? Or was it just like out? Kind of. Like, was still rolled up?
Yes.
Oh, so you never put it on? So he like opened the package up, but he never put it on.
Right.
Is that what happened?
I think so.
That's a cold blooded killer right there. That's a cold blooded killer right there.
But it looked like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it looked like it was used.
Mm-hmm.
But I was just like, at the same time, you know, because lube is supposed to be on the outside, right?
Yeah.
Of a condom.
Yeah.
So it looked like maybe that's what that was too. I don't know. But then, like, I want to say, couple weeks later, maybe 6 to 8 weeks later, the questions that he was asking me, it was just like,
what was the question?
Like, how are you feeling? And mind you, we hadn't spoke
yeah
in like a couple weeks.
Okay.
So it was just weird, like the way that it popped up. And then, you know, the way that I found out at work, I had a incident at work,
mm-hmm.
and they had to take me to the hospital, and he was still my emergency contact at the time.
Yeah.
So, of course, the hospital.
That's a wild way to find out.
It was the worst.
You sound like one of the characters on Euphoria. Like the wildest thing happened, and you find out, I'm having a baby.
Man, it was the worst. But yeah.
So, did you confront him?
I think the doctor could tell there was tension, so the doctor removed himself.
Yeah.
And it got live. It got real, real live, real fast, but it was...
You hit him with a bottle of sanitizer?
Of course not.
Look at his face. Yeah. Oh, never.
I didn't. I just, you know...
We use our words.
Yeah, at that moment we had to, because, you know, neither one of us wanted to go to jail, but... Crazy situation.
Did somebody come back in and try to calm you guys down, or the doctors kind of let y'all have your moment?
They let it go on for just a second, and somebody came back in, like, you know, we're here now.
So. Yeah. that's going to be the name of the episode, We Here Now.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to shift a little bit. Not too much.
This is evil.
Who's better at giving marketing speeches? The pastor at a funeral, or the person that puts Plan B next to the condoms in the grocery store or Walgreens or whatever?
I would say the pastor.
Yeah.
At a funeral.
Because he gets you with that emotional speech.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Honestly, he plays on your emotions.
Yeah.
And it's like the work of the devil. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, you're in God's house, so you're like, yeah.
Okay.
It's definitely not the person that
pimping.
Because not too many people use condoms anymore, so nobody really sees those.
But Plan Bs?
Nobody uses
Plan Bs.
You have to go and like intentionally be going to go get those.
Yeah. No. I do know people that buy the Plan Bs because they know that it's gonna be a weekend.
Man,
shooting it up all weekend.
All right. So is it men or women that you know that's doing, that's buying these?
Actually, I heard the story from women. And actually, what's funny, I just got hip to this. So I guess it works 3 days before and 3 days after, which I did not know.
I didn't know that either.
Right. So I didn't know. So that's new information to me. But a woman told me that. And then they'd take you like, been a while out this weekend. Like, yeah, that was news to me.
It ain't black women, is it?
Yeah.
It ain't black women.
Yeah.
We don't do that.
No.
We don't do that. It's craziness.
Shoot the club up.
We be out here civilized and whatnot.
Right. That face would never.
Never.
Just the hardcore section is on the phone.
You didn't even ask me when that was. That could have been at any point in my life. It's not necessarily right now. But,
yeah. I didn't know you were going to, you know, go your whole life with your search history, you know, but what? You know.
It's okay. Next.
Who's better? About to apply more pressure. Who's better applying pressure? Homeless people at the off-ramp or pro-lifers at the abortion clinic?
Homeless people at the off-ramp.
Well, because I'm like, damn, it's a long light. And they got that one dude with time.
Yeah, they be ready to damn near get in your car with you.
All right, modified question. I got to throw this on there. Who's worse, the water boys or the homeless people with the signs?
The water boys.
Water boys, they more aggressive, right?
Yeah, they will, like, be all in your car. Like, come on, Ma, like, you know what I'm out here doing this for. Like, get a,
Wait. These New York water boys or Atlanta water boys? These like, oh, fam.
They just mix out here.
They, okay.
They just link together and they talk about which corner they're getting ready to hit. Yeah.
Oh, that's why
it's
so bad. Yeah. Everywhere. Okay.
Yeah. So, everybody out there.
Okay.
It's all bad.
Well, somebody put their arm in your window and reach in your change.
Be like, I'm trying to tell you.
And I see your change right there.
Like, yo. Like,
all that silver right there.
I have lunch money. You all in here.
You good.
The hell?
You gave it to him, though, because you were scared?
No.
Pulled off. With him still in the car?
Yep.
He skinned his legs up?
Nah, he just did those quick spin real quick.
Whoa, you said that like it was for real.
Yeah,
you see him again? Because you know they be working the same corners.
Nah, I just take a different route. I ain't got time to play with them. I'll be on a mission.
Yeah. Have you ever seen...
Keep in mind, that's somebody's baby.
So yeah, yeah, yeah. Have you ever seen the same homeless people like working their same like parking lots and stuff?
Yes. It's very unfortunate.
Well, it's unfortunate, but, well, I have a dark humor. Mm-hmm. So certain situations like, oh, okay, yes, this is what you do. Because I think one time what happened to me is I had a job. I was working part-time. It was like a four-hour shift, but I was like somebody's ride. So I kind of just hung out in the spot. Yeah. And there was a girl who looked like she was in good health, didn't have anything wrong with her. And it's like, you ever look at a person, we judging, but at the same time, it's like they look like they're not homeless. Mm-hmm. Like you look too healthy and too clean.
Yeah.
She was like one of those, but she was like, her hustle was a $2 hustle. It was like, hey, I got lost without my wallet and my purse. Can you just give me $2 so I can catch this bus so I can get back to my side of town? I came in to work on my off day and they wouldn't let me work. So I just basically hung out until my coworkers came back out until we were going to do what we were going to do. But I watched this girl make no less than like $200, $300 in a span of like 4 hours. And it's like the hustle was so immaculate. And I felt so bad. I'm like, damn, I'm not doing this life thing right.
Yeah, you got it all wrong. You better find a corner somewhere. Water or
I don't think anybody gonna like, ain't your beard too crispy. Ain't nobody giving you no money,
That's
boy.
True. We already know. You just went to the barbershop this past Friday.
Your beard too shiny, man. I need more struggle in your beard.
Yeah. I hear plenty.
You know what's something crazy that you learned is not necessarily like common knowledge until like people start talking about. Because I ran into something real. Oh, I'll let you think about it. I'll tell you mine. So I didn't think about this until I brought it up. Retelling a story about I had a little back and forth with one of my teachers in school, and I guess I was just explaining my nuclear family and my brother. who has a different dad than I do. And I was like, yeah, my brother. And then the teacher was like, "Who's you guys have the same father?" And I was like, no. And I was like, and then she was like, oh, so it's your half-brother. I was like, no, it's my whole brother. I see him every day. And then I really didn't get the concept because I've never heard the term half-sibling before. Mm-hmm. And she was trying to explain a half-sibling. And I'm like, I don't understand that.
Yeah.
And then I had to have a conversation with some other adults outside of school, and they had to give it to me. And I'm like, oh, yeah, we don't do that. But what I realized upon talking to different people from different races, mm-hmm. black people, most of black people, unless you have a person that grew up with a married family, mm-hmm. and all the families, all the kids were in the household, most people don't say that's my half brother, half sister, that they just say that's my brother, my sister.
Yeah.
And so that's where the confusion came from. But same time, that's one weird thing that I learned. You got anything like that?
Mine is about those facilities that pay you for your sperm or your eggs.
Okay.
I thought, you know, they just took anybody.
Okay. Yeah, I learned the hard way.
Okay. So.
No, I was going to try to sell some, and it's like, oh, we're looking for white men, blonde hair, blue eyes. And it's like.
Yeah. I didn't know that they had like a criteria. Mm-hmm. That you had to meet to do this. Because mm-hmm. in the back of my mind, you know, certain seasons you see more homeless people than other seasons.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess that's the way.
Yeah. I didn't think about it until you said it, but yeah.
I was just in the back of my mind when I started seeing these, like, billboards and, like, you would see it on social media, just different places about these facilities willing to compensate you for your eggs or your sperm. You start to think, like, why are there so many homeless people? Because mm-hmm. the amount that they're willing to pay you for it is crazy, like thousands of dollars. So you're like,
oh, I ain't know they gave it up like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
They giving it up like.
Can I lie on my application? I gotta verify me. Man.
Like $30,000 for surrogate.
That's some student loans.
You're crazy. But yeah, I didn't know. And when I would talk about it with other people, because at one point it was like a promotion going on, like around the holiday season for Christmas going mm-hmm. on, and I shared it on social media.
Okay.
And I had people hopping in my inbox like, hey, you know, I called and they said you got to be, it was more than one person. So I was like, damn, like, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
They were like, yeah, they wanted you to be like 130 pounds. And who the f- is 130 pounds out here?
That's for the women? Mm-hmm. 130 pounds. Why was the weight criteria thing?
I don't know. I didn't ask.
That's to be a surrogate?
Yeah.
Okay.
To be a surrogate. Or to even, like, donate your eggs. They wanted you to be at most 130 pounds.
Were?
Yeah.
No matter what height you were? Mm-mm. Really?
And I think she was shorter than me. Mm-hmm. So it may go by height and that type of thing. But it just seems unrealistic because she's not that much shorter than me. Hmm. I probably got her by 2 inches.
Mm-hmm.
And I ain't seen 130 pounds since high school.
Yeah.
So
I was about to ask, but this was kind of more intriguing.
So that'd probably be the.
Well, that and Plan B, I just hit you with.
Yeah,
like 3 days before and after. Like, really? I could take a Friday, Saturday, Sunday off.
Man, nobody using them things.
You said no. Mm-mm. You ain't doing it.
No.
If it happens, it happens.
Listen, YOLO.
No, that's what you're on. Straight to the meats. Straight to the meats. All right. So I got a beef with people. I guess I'm just like a weird place to do a PSA, but I'm going to do it anyway. So I was talking to, I had this happen with two different guys in my, that shall remain nameless. But.
Nah, put them on blast.
I can't. I already put them in blast for real life. I ain't going to do it on hot mic. But anyway, one person called, both of them called me. But I think people need to let the other person know if you have them on speakerphone. Because you're liable to say something wild, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I had one guy, last time I talked to him, it was like, I want to say a few months in between the conversations. Mm-hmm. But the last time I talked to him, the girl that he was seeing, they had broken up, and she didn't have a name. Her name was that bitch. Let me tell you about that bitch. That's what her name was.
Yeah.
And then he calls me now I didn't know they made up. And mm-hmm. not only did they make up, but they're back together and they're living back together. And mm-hmm. not only are they back together in the same household, he has me on speakerphone while she's in the kitchen, never tells me. And I just ask, hey, where you at? He's like, oh, I'm at home. Which one? You at your mama's house or you got a new spot?
Okay.
And he's like, no, I'm back home. Okay. I said, so what's up with you? And I say the girl's name.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, she right here. And then I hear her like, you know, like somebody on the stove when they start clanking stuff.
Yeah.
Like I can tell that aggressive clank. Mm-hmm. Like you been talking about me.
Yeah.
Yeah. She hit me with one of those without saying anything. And I'm like, yo, you got me on speaker? Mm. He's like, yeah, but it's all good. She know we be arguing. Like, dude, why are you making me that guy now? Because every time I come in the living room, it's going to be that tension. Like, mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Why would you put me in that position?
Yeah, I've had that.
And then was like, don't let anybody in your family find out. Or like, you know, if you dating somebody and the family knows them or whatever, yeah. Maybe you guys built that relationship. So you have that part. But the other aspect of it is this. It's like, when they break up and then the family finds out about, you know, other situations, or if they, you know, they bring their side pieces to the family function, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Some people wild like that. Yeah. And, you know, little kids, they don't have any, you know, discretion. They're like, what Miss Janice said? She said she was going to do my hair last time. Oh, shut the fuck up. Don't look like you. You said you was going to do my hair last time. I didn't say that, baby. Uh-huh, because mm-hmm. last time you had on these blue jeans and these open toes. Like, I got a myth. I got family members like that.
Yeah.
And then, yo, my the guy, he was so hot. But what can you say to a little kid? Because you brought, you shouldn't have been, that was your fault for being reckless, right?
Exactly.
That's yep. the same thing about a person putting you on speakerphone.
That's crazy. I've been in all of those situations.
Well, speakerphone, what you say on the hot mic?
I say everything. That'd be the problem. But now I think everybody is at the point where if I'm calling, they just get up and remove themselves if they're with somebody else.
Okay.
Because I'm going to say whatever I got to say.
Right.
So,
But people got to say you if you're on speakerphone, right?
Yeah, they never do, which why? Is fine.
Okay, if you know somebody's going to pop off, why don't they say it?
I don't know.
Or why not take it off speakerphone? Okay.
But so, then my conversations do be random, too.
Like me too. Well, you know me. I'm random as hell, but...
Yeah.
All right, so what was the most flagrant thing you said on a hot mic with the, you know... With a little piece on the side.
Oh, damn. What was I saying?
I think. Hey, that girl you brought to the party, she said got the, she said got food stamps because I need them. What girl? Who?
I was talking to a family member.
I've been knowing. She had bundles.
I was talking to a family member,
mm-hmm.
and damn, what happened? I think they were outside, or they started off in the house, and they came outside because I was on the phone.
Yeah,
of course. And then he was grilling,
okay.
And I was talking about coming to visit,
mm-hmm.
and my friend was in the background where I was at, and she was like, "Yeah, I'm coming too." So I was like, "Cool." And I know it was on speakerphone. I heard his girl walk out the house.
Yeah.
And his girl was like, who are you talking to? I feel like she was standing at the door the whole time.
Yeah.
But I'm going to keep talking because, you know what I'm saying, it's what it is. And I was like, listen, we can come stay with y'all. Or we can go to the hotel. You can come to the hotel where we at.
Word?
Yeah, straight like that.
You a wild boy.
It was what it was.
It was what it is. So,
it was that, and then what else did you say?
The family bring somebody to the cookout, and then another person put them on blast or something like that. It was something similar to that. That was funny because I remember. All right, so I'm the type of person I get my laughs the most off of people watching. So when you see the drama unfolding,
mm-hmm.
and you don't even need to hear it unfold, you can just see the body language. You like. And then they pull them off to the side. I'm like, you told me to do that. I'm about to something. I told you. He don't know. He has a kid. You don't believe a kid over me? You gonna believe a kid over me?
Yeah, that's what I was talking about.
Okay.
Yes.
You brought you back. Yes. Okay.
So So I've been the mistaken girlfriend. Like there was a kid that came up and she was like, ooh, hey, such and such, call me a whole different name and everything. Word? Yeah. And it was that situation. He said, you was going to do my hair and can you do it now? And, then it was another situation where they came up and told me that there was somebody else just over here yesterday. So they thought
Little kids, you in. But I mean, but you know, that's the dude fault though. That's the dude fault. It's the dude fault.
Messy. Messy.
And how'd you play it?
You play. Like, oh, okay. That's what's up. That's what's up. I can do to your the hair. Kid. Yeah.
Okay, to so what'd you say to the dude? That's what we on? No, you don't find that suspicious?
Not even like that. I was like, yeah, I think you should call Shorty.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think you should do that.
They trip over their tongue. See, that one would have. No, they were talking about.
It's straight. Y'all got unfinished business. Let me just remove my.
Did you know about who the girl was before?
Yeah, I've heard her
name. Okay.
Because it wasn't just the kid. Like, the whole family was just messy.
Okay. So, damn.
Yeah, it was.
Yo, you got a bad track record with families, yo.
No, not for real. Families.
No, I'm talking about, like, you know what I'm saying? Weird situations and stories with the family, with the cookout.
It always starts,
you got
though,
PTSD at cookouts.
Make it me always a plate. Starts because there's a lot of.
Your hand just starts shaking.
It's a lot of moms that, you know, don't want to let go of their sons. You know, they feel like they got to be first, you know. And
speak more on that.
Like, just period. They don't want to let go of their son. Like, if they feel like their son is giving more attention or more anything to another female, they feel threatened.
Okay, this is, like, I'm guessing these are single moms.
Not even.
Really?
Not even. And that's the weird part. I would expect that from a single mom.
More so than a woman that has a man or husband. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But that's
the. So it's just like you taking mama's baby away or what? That's what
basically,
it is?
Basically, yeah. Okay. That's what it seemed like. But then it wasn't even that, because it's, you know, like I said, I would expect that from a single mom, and maybe from a single mom that maybe that's your only.
Mm-hmm.
But. Got three or four more running.
Yeah, but that's my favorite.
Man. Yeah, I
he played that. My numbers in, bring the groceries to the house.
Had to dead that real quick. I ain't got time.
How many times have you had a situation like that?
Three times.
How did the moms approach you? Did they just kind of like do like some catty stuff, or were they more subtle? Like, what was their approach? They had, call the guy for favors, and he had to get up and go run. Well, he didn't have to, but he would do it.
Yeah, two of them were like that. The mothers were catty and, like, do some, like, real messy stuff at gatherings or, like, hit them up. We could be talking about something at a gathering, like, I'm getting ready to prepare for, like, something coming up or whatever.
Yeah.
And they made sure they hit them on that day. That I got
basically see where his priorities lie.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the other one, she was straight.
Oh, they forward. Like that's like having a woman, like them or ex wife or baby mama that don't want to let go.
I wouldn't know nothing about that. But the other one, she was straightforward with it. She was straightforward. She was letting me know this is my baby, you know, my only son, and you know, you only get one. And I think later on in life, it was for her. She was trying to get a second chance at being a parent. So
to make up for the lost time with him? Okay.
So I was kind of in the way of that, so to speak, because he started spending a lot of time with me when they were actually in the same space.
How old were you at the time? Well, you guys, both you guys? 20s?
Nah, we were a little bit younger than that.
Oh, okay. I understand that then.
Yeah.
I still see your frustration, but I can understand where that would they would try to make up for lost time.
Yeah.
Like, was she on drugs? Was she just absentee parent, or what was it?
I think both.
Okay. Both. Yeah. What I notice with parents that are on drugs, and they try to, like, circle the wagons and, I guess, heal the old wounds of the things that they caused, they kind of get stuck in this, like, time continuum, and they don't have a sense of time. It's like, you're 17 now, but you burnt the bridge with that kid, or broke the bond essentially with the person when they were like 9, 10, 11. Mm-hmm. And that's a lot of time in a child's development where they kind of formulate an idea or separate themselves from you mentally.
Yeah.
For you to just come back like they were just you know, they're playing with different, they had cartoon underwear last time y'all were close. Mm-hmm. Now,
but I respected that mother more. I respect that mother more than the other two that were just, you know what I'm saying, like doing shit on the sly. I respected the one that was straightforward, like admitting her mistakes and all that.
Yeah.
And trying to do things the right
way.
Did
she try to sabotage you though? Or is it more so like she's the best in social? I'm trying to make up for lost time.
Basically.
Okay, I can respect that.
I don't think she was trying to sabotage us at all. Because at one point she was even like, you know, they were here for a minute and they was like, oh, you know, we're going to move back to New York and try to do this, put this family back together.
Okay.
Type thing. It was this like, why don't you come with us? So it was like, you know.
Pressure. Ooh, that's pressure right there,
yeah,
boy.
Yeah, it was a lot.
That's a lot
like,
of pressure.
That's my dog. Like, don't get twisted. That's my dog.
Oh, bro, you know it's on for you. If a girl say, oh, that's my dog. That's my, you know what I'm saying?
That's my,
you know what I mean?
But like,
ooh,
child.
They get all the seasons. Every year, without fail. let's see. It'll come to the cards. One to the cards. Black Friday sales. Oh, is there an age limit on things like tongue rings, piercings, colored hair, wild tattoos? Like, all right, it'll be wild for somebody to get a face tattoo at 47, right? And if they have no tattoos, they just come in hot with the eyebrow joint.
That's not subtle at all. I mean, I guess that's what you'd be going for if you got to start at 47.
That's just, like, I don't know where I pull up that number from. I just threw it out there.
But legally, it's the age on piercings and tattoos. But, like, I don't, legally, yeah.
To start?
Yes.
Oh, start, yeah, I know that. I'm talking about the other side. I'm dealing with grown folks.
Yeah. Piercings, yeah. Depending on what your body already looked like.
So it's body. If your check engine light on, you can't make certain body modifications. Is what you're saying?
Yeah. Because why?
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
You gotta just be doing it for the look of it.
Yeah. What if they 50 and they just find that hardcore section that you've been on?
I need for them to have a partner that's utilizing those piercings and whatnot.
Okay.
Just doing it for you, it don't make no sense. If nobody else is seeing it or touching it or playing with it, it doesn't make sense.
I mean, you know, people go through midlife crisis. I'm like, all right, in the second half of my life, I'm going to be a badass. I'm going to be a rebel.
That's true.
Yeah.
You can get you a little flower or something on your wrist. You know, a little butterfly somewhere.
It's money. Oh, I was about to say,
not you, per
like, I don't have any ink. Like, I'm gonna come in with a butterfly. That's...
I mean, something subtle, something small. You gotta start off small before you go big.
Yeah. Speaking of which, didn't you say you were gonna get a sleeve or something?
I didn't say a sleeve per se.
I thought you. What did you modify? What are you gonna do?
I was trying to be like Lil Wayne. I was gonna get the whole drum, like mine is my face.
Cause, yeah.
You know, it's right here, the breadwinner.
Yeah.
But like. I'm trying to, you know, get the full body going on. You know
what I'm saying? Okay, it's gonna be real like scripture all over.
Scriptures, pictures.
What's the most sensitive area for you to get your tattoo? Like, which one hurt the worst?
I don't know about pain,
like bone on bone action, or they just hit a nerve.
It would be. I think my most uncomfortable one was. My ankle, in the front of my ankle.
Straight bone? That's why?
Yeah, because it is nothing but, you know, my shit ain't meaty.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And she's still not 130. Can't sell them eggs. No, would you do that? What? With the right price tag in front of you?
Sell my eggs?
Yeah, like carry the baby?
Oh, surrogate.
Yeah.
I almost did. What was and I was excited about it, too.
Really?
But it didn't work out.
What happened? They pulled out. no pun intended.
No. What happened with her? She the last appointment she attended before the appointment that I was supposed to attend with her.
Mm-hmm.
The doctor went to collect another egg, and that was it.
No, she was able to have it.
Yeah, she wasn't. No, she wasn't able to produce another one for him to collect. So it was sad because she had multiple miscarriages before.
Yeah.
So her and her husband had, I think, three kids of his own.
Okay, so he was basically trying to do one for her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think she had 6 miscarriages with him.
Oh, that's a lot.
So
that's painful.
It was a tough situation.
That's so painful.
And I happened to know someone in her husband's family, and they kind of talked me into it. And they were just like, you know, we don't expect you to have our baby and, like, go about your business. You know, you could still come around and stuff like that. Because I think that was one of the concerns for me. Because just, you know, being a mom already.
Yeah.
I know.
And then, well, I know you guys built that bond, too, when you're carrying this child. So it's like.
Yeah. Like, they wanted me to live in-house and everything. Mm-hmm. Like, they were going to pay me to stop working. Like, the whole shebang. So yeah. I was with it. I was like, you know, they were going to move me and my daughter in. And
what was the number?
The whole,
did they have a price tag they threw on the table?
To start, it was going to be $16,000.
Whew. Okay.
And then, monthly, it was going to increase.
I almost said I carry it.
monthly, it would have increased depending on the circumstances. Because they wanted to know how my pregnancy went. And
okay,
I explained
okay.
that to them, and they were like, okay. And I explained to them, I worked my whole pregnancy. Mm-hmm. So that was going to, just that alone, them not wanting me to work at all,
yeah.
that was going to be tough for me. Because...
Yeah, because you're not used to just being sitting at the house.
I would have felt like I was being taken care of.
Yeah,
and that was gonna make me feel
is that a
like
problem
emotionally?
For you?
Emotionally, yeah.
I mean, like from a relationship standpoint, like is that something you struggle with? Like, I've actually, well, one of my long term relationships, our first argument, it happened like after maybe 2-3 years, and it was because she wouldn't let me help her. But she like a lot of women, they are so used to being independent mm-hmm. and not having people do things for them. They don't know how to accept help, or they just outright reject it. Is that something that you struggle with?
Yes. Yes and no. If it's something small, then, you know, by all means.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's, like, something big,
yeah,
I'm, like, more hesitant.
Why is that? You're afraid of disappointment, or you're afraid if someone comes through so many times and then you start to expect it and then they can let you down?
No, it's just because I tend to think about what else they have on their plate.
Okay.
And I start to feel like maybe what I need is a burden or could be a burden.
You just don't want to be a burden to exactly. someone's life.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
How have you changed or modified that thought process at this point in life, or is it still a thing?
Yeah, because I'm getting older and I have more responsibilities and it's just not me.
Yeah.
You know, my child's getting older. Mm-hmm. They need more attention.
Yeah.
More financially, that whole thing. And, of course, it takes a toll on me.
Yeah.
And so it affects me emotionally, financially, spiritually, yeah. all of that.
Mm-hmm.
So someone willing to take that, I guess, off my shoulders.
Yeah,
it feels better now than it would have a couple of years ago. A couple of years ago, I was a jack of all trades. I could do it by myself. I'm good. I don't need no help.
Where did you get to the point in your life, or was there a particular moment, or was it like just something gradual? And you said, I'm tripping. I'm doing too much.
Health wise.
Okay, you had a health scare.
Yeah.
What happened? You got sick or what happened?
When my daughter was younger, I think I was like maybe 23, 24. I had a heart attack.
Oh, wow.
And I was away from my family. So when they found out, they were like, oh, no, you got to move back. You got to move back to Georgia. And we don't like that you by yourself. And it was mm-hmm. like, you know, me, I wanted to, okay, wait, let me find a place to stay. Let me transfer my job, all of that.
Yeah.
They wasn't waiting for none of that. Mm-hmm. It was like, we have a room for you.
Yeah.
Just come.
Okay.
So that was hard.
Yeah.
Because I wasn't. Like, I like to be prepared. No matter what it is, I like to be prepared, and I feel mm-hmm. like I wasn't.
Yeah.
So it was that. I've always had a heart condition, mm-hmm. but when I was younger,
regular heartbeat, or is it too
big? I had aneurysm in my aorta.
Okay.
So I was taking medication for it at mm-hmm. one point, and then it was just like, I felt like it wasn't doing anything,
mm-hmm.
because every time I went to the hospital after that, it was like, once I was off the medication, It's almost like my body was self-healing.
Okay.
So it kind of turned me off of taking medication.
Okay.
Like, period, for anything.
Yeah.
So.
So what were the circumstances when you had the heart attack? Was it something that was triggered by your life, or was it just a gradual condition that broke down and led to that moment?
I think it was a lot that was happening at that time.
Mm-hmm.
Change of scenery.
Mm-hmm.
Job changed. My vehicle broke down at the same time, different types of stress. Everything. Yeah. I had to figure out visitation for my daughter because we were no longer in the same state.
Yeah.
I felt like, you know, I was the only person trying to figure out visitation.
Yeah.
So it was all of that.
Okay.
All of that at the same time. So I chalked it up to stress.
Okay. So now you just don't care?
I don't care. It's just, you know, I don't let you more get to me anymore.
You're more apathetic, or you just like you just find yourself in a situation where like something that would usually take you to an average person to a 10 or 8 or 10, you would be like, nah, 6, 7 at the most.
If that.
Yeah.
If that. No.
Do you upset people because of that?
Yeah. Not on purpose, like, you know, of course I don't do it on purpose.
Yeah. I mean, but honestly, if a person doesn't know what happened to you, they just think that you just don't care and you're willy-nilly about things.
Mm-hmm.
So is that, do you not care or you just don't showcase it the way the old you would internalize things?
I would say it depends on who the person is. Like, if I really fuck with you for real, and I really know you and your heart and is in a good place and all that, I'm willing to explain to you anything.
Okay.
And why I feel how earned. I feel.
Yeah.
Why I feel how I feel, and you know what made me that type of person, and you know why I am accepting of some things and why I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
But like, if we ain't that deep,
yeah,
listen, you get this is what it is, and
take it or leave it. That's what it is. Yeah. All right.
You know, no disrespect, no shade, no.
Right. Yeah. It just is what it is. Yeah. All right, so before I like to end the episode, I'd like to give you an opportunity to talk about anything you want to talk about or things you want to ask me, something you've seen, or just any questions that you want to throw. What you got? Why don't they get more sauce at the drive-thru?
Man, them folks act like it's coming out their check. They get on my nerves. I don't even do fast food no more, though. I'll be cooking. So.
What's your cook list? Everything. Do a lot of pastas?
I do.
Yeah.
They quick and they stick.
Yeah. Rice or noodles?
Rice.
A lot of rice. You do more Caribbean foods, or what's your style? Like, what do you like more spicy?
I try to tap into everything. See, the whole spicy thing, I'm big on spicy and hot foods.
Yeah.
But, you know, those
hardcore in and out.
All of that. Those on the receiving end, not so much. So I got to kind of stay away from the spices.
All right. What's the spiciest thing that you make or what's your go-to spicy meal?
Curry chicken.
But curry not that spicy. I'm sorry, I just got educated because I thought jerk was the only thing that was spicy, but I've had some curry that's spicy. I was like,
I stay away from the jerk altogether because there's no way to not make it spicy.
Yeah.
So.
The first time I had some jerk, I was down here. I was working with an artist, and I did a food run for everybody, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I stopped at the little Jamaican's joint. And she's like, "Yeah, get the jerk." And I'm like, "I've never had it before." And I'm like, "I don't know, you know, I ain't know what to get." Mm-hmm. So I was like trying to get like a sampler plate. She's like, "Well, get me this." She got the jerk, and I got the curry. And then you know, you get the little pick off the people plates and stuff, whatever, right? And everything that I had flushed out. But it was so good, though. It was so problematic, but at the same time, it was such a toxic relationship. Like, this is bad for me, but it.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it was.
I've seen that.
They should give you Kleenex when they give you that damn jerk chicken, boy, because I was.
You got me wanting some sauce. For real. I ain't gonna lie. I might pull up
some jerk
when I leave here. Yeah. You got some links to send me. Don't forget, because I'm not.
No, we watch them links together. We watch them links together.
Because
I need to see those reactions,
okay,
and I need to be taped.
Links. Okay.
Say it again.
I need the food links.
Oh, the food links. I got that. I got them. Okay. I got you.
I don't care who you sit in here with. I'm definitely gonna listen.
She talking to me like I'm on speakerphone with everybody. You know what I'm like, I don't care who in your phone coming
next.
But don't forget what you had told me, because that's important.
Because I pull back up.
Well, up then. I ain't scared. All right.
And I'm not gonna
my forehead just, you know, it's the light that make my forehead sweaty. Yo, you better get up out of here. You got anything you want to add? You
have happy Black History Month.
Oh, yeah. Hey. You know, I celebrate all the time, you know what I'm saying? You know what it is. You know,
because we out here.
All Black everything. Thank you guys for your time. If you think we got it right, you think we got it wrong, go to the comments, say it with your chest, be respectful. We're going to keep doing this. Thank you for coming out, being problematic. But but no, forever, I appreciate you pulling up. It's always fun. Always a pleasure. Let's do this again. Live from the living room. Peace.